game number 5 between the Toronto Furies and Brampton HC. My name is Mark Trophy. I'm joined today by Team Canada defenseman as well as Alberta defenseman, Megan Mickelson. Megan, what can we expect from today's game?
Well, it's going to be a hard-fought battle, I think, here between Brampton and Toronto. A must-win game for Brampton as Boston plays Montreal this afternoon. If Boston beats Montreal and Brampton loses this game, then it'll come down to goals for and against as to who will play in the final tomorrow. So Brampton really needs to come out, play hard, and ensure that they win this game tonight so that they are in that gold medal game tomorrow.
Now, what does Brampton have to do most to defend against Toronto and make sure that they can score the goals?
Well, I think it comes down to, I guess, taking care of your own end first. That's always something that you think about going into a game. Playing good defense, and the offense will take care of itself. Brampton obviously has a lot of depth on their team on forward. There's Jillian Apps, Jaina Hefford, Sherry Piper, Lori Dupuy, Vicky Bendis. So taking care of their own end, and I think the offense will take care of itself after that.
Toronto, on the other hand, they're looking pretty good in the tournament thus far. Tessa Bonhomme is, of course, one of the defensemen to watch in this game, as well as on forward you have Mallory Deluce. So what can you tell us more about that?
Tessa Bonhomme, a very skilled, dynamic offensive defenseman, member of the Canadian national team, 2010 Olympic gold medalist, definitely one of the players to watch tonight, as well as Jesse Scanzano, Mallory Deluce, as you said, both very skilled forwards that are able to put the puck in the net. They're used to playing a lot of minutes, and I think they'll see a lot of ice time today.
It's going to be a great game here at the Gale Center in Niagara Falls for the Clarkson Cup between Toronto and Brampton. Now, you play on the Canadian national team. What can you tell us about some of the national team players that we'll see here tonight?
Well, there are a lot of national team players out on the ice this morning. Like you said, I've played with a lot of them, and I've played against a lot of them as well. We just played Brampton last weekend in Calgary. Unfortunately, they swept us 2 games, but... like I said, a lot of good forwards. And on defense, they have Courtney Burchard, who is was the rookie of the year in this league and is one of the best defensemen coming up in the national team program. So definitely another player to watch here. The goaltenders have been outstanding so far in this tournament. So watching Liz Knox, watching her play yesterday morning, I mean, she just played absolutely phenomenal. So it's going to be a really great game this morning.
It's going to be great to look forward to. It's going to be a great game for the fans here at the Gale Center, as well as us to watch and to call. So stay with us here on Kojiko TV as we go down for the national anthems.
Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to introduce this young lady from Welland, Ontario. From a musical family, she carries the tradition
on. I do that all the time.
And her voice is something to be heard. So let's make her all feel welcome as she leads us into singing of the anthem of our great country, Miss Bethany LaLama.
Oh, Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all our sons coming. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true north strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O stand on guard for thee, O Canada.
Thank you, Breton Lalama from Notre Dame College School in Welland.
Great rendition there of the national anthem to kick off our game coverage here on TV Kojiko of Game 5 of the Clarkson Cup between the Toronto Furies as well as Brampton HC. Again, my name is Mark Joffe alongside with Megan Mickelson. So this is going to be a great game. We're going to look at a lot of national players from Team Canada and Team US. But what can you share about the goalies?
The goalies, there's Liz Knox. Sorry, my mic was lowered there. Liz Knox, I was saying earlier what an amazing game she had yesterday against Montreal, holding them to just 2 goals. She was outstanding. She had 30 shots on her and absolutely stood on her head. For Toronto, we have... it is
Erica
Vanderveer. In the last 2 games, we've seen Sammy Jo Small in the net. So with Erica getting the start today, obviously she's a great goaltender as well. Playing in this league, all the goalies are outstanding. So I think it'll be great to watch them and see what they bring.
Yeah, Erica Vanderveer, of course, getting the start over the veteran Sammy Jo Small in this league. There you see the referee Marianne Gage and Melanie Bordelot, as well as Jen McMahon and Andrea Skinner on the lines. So we're ready for hockey here in Niagara Falls at the Gale Center as the puck drops to begin the first period here between Toronto and Brampton. Fox plays the puck across to Engstrom now as Fox will take the puck. She'll play it up here for Laurie Dupuis. Plays it all the way across. Ironside, now the shot. That one goes high and wide. Looks like it hit a stick in front. Battle down in the corner now for the puck. Toronto comes away with it. That's Tessa Bonham. She'll play the puck across. This one's played all the way up to center as Engstrom will play it out. Bonham will take it. Skates over center. Tessa Bonham. Of course, Megan mentioned here on the national team for Canada, as well as the winner of Battle of the Blades this year. So a very interesting fact about that. Hefford skates over center ice and she is checked. Hoffmeyer plays the puck all the way across. This one's played up over center ice and down deep into Brampton territory. Toronto touches it to wave off the icing call here as this one's played in the corner. Plays it around. Deep in the corner, Allie Fox will pick it off here. She plays it up for Hefford, who cannot handle it. This one's played all the way up. Kept in there by Engstrom. Riggs trying to center it in front for Hefford, but cannot. This one's stolen here. That's McPhail, and we have a whistle here on the ice. Looks like it'll be an offside call. Now, Megan, what have you seen thus far in this game that really Brampton needs to do to win?
Well, Brampton is a very good puck-moving team. They move the puck really well across the ice, creating space and time for their players to carry the puck into the offensive end. So I think what we've seen so far, both teams are putting the pressure on, trying to get the puck in deep and putting pressure on the defensemen.
And Arts now with the puck in the corner there. This one's played out. Still has the puck. Skating around the net. Tries to wrap around. That one's in front. There's a shot. Knocked aside there by Liz Knox. Arts trying to center the puck out for Bonello, but that one goes all the way down and into the Toronto territory.
You'll see Jillian Apps was on the puck there. She is a very fast, big, strong, power forward, but has a lot of skill as well. Speaking as a defenseman, she's very difficult to defend. Anytime you see her coming down the ice, she's 6 feet tall. You know that as a defenseman, you're going to have to make a great play to move around her.
We got a penalty here coming to Brampton number 11. That's Vicky Bendis that will take the penalty here as Toronto will get their first power play of the game. Let's see if Toronto can capitalize on this man advantage here as Bonham will play it across. Smith plays it up. And Brittany Smith has it at the point. Plays it down low. All the way back to the point for Smith, who kicks it to her stick. She'll play it for Tessa Benham.
Tessa Benham showing a lot of poise up on the blue line there.
This one's taken by Jaina Heffert as she will skate all the way in to Toronto territory. Shot very easily turned aside there by Vanderveer.
Jaina Heffert is a great penalty killer. She plays a lot of PK minutes on the national team. And anytime she's out there and you're on the power play, you know that you're going to have to make a great play and a great move to get the puck around her when she's defending you at the point there.
Smith now with the puck at the point. Plays it for Deleuze, who cannot handle it. Hits her skate, and as Allie Fox takes it and will get it just out of her own zone there. This one's blocked by Sherry Piper as she goes after it in Toronto territory behind the net. But I'm checking. Zamora comes away with it. Kelly Zamora takes the puck now. She's going to play it all the way across, trying to find Scanzano, but she cannot. Molly Engstrom takes the puck into Toronto territory, plays it down near the corner. So it's played all the way out now as Jillian Apps will take it. Apps throws it all the way down into the corner. Vanderveer will play it here, and she will play it for her defenseman. Toronto takes the puck all the way up. Zamora plays it in but cannot get it by Lori Dupuis.
Brampton doing a great job here of reading the play and picking off the passes.
This one's played on the side boards here for Toronto, playing with the puck a lot here on this power play. Scanzano will take the puck here. Bendis' penalty has expired. She is out of the box here as Brampton is back to even strength here as Bendis will pick the puck up in her own zone and play it all the way across. This one's taken. A little bit of a slip there by Hoffmeyer. This one's played in front. Liz Knox makes a nice save and covers it up for a faceoff.
A great penalty kill there by Brampton. Like I said, making great reads on the play. You saw Molly Engstrom pick off that pass at center ice. Lori Dupuis picked off another pass in the defensive end. So a great kill for Brampton, and hopefully it will give them some momentum here moving forward.
Toronto wins the draw here as Mallory Deleuze will take it. This one's tipped all the way out. Trying to keep it in there is Toronto, and they do still have it. Mallory Deleuze has it on her stick. She'll play it all the way back to the point. Here's a shot. That one's blocked in front. A lot of traffic in front. Couldn't get that shot all the way through. This one goes all the way down the Toronto territory as Vanderveer will take it. She plays it out. This one's played all the way across here as Bowman will play the puck up.
Vanderveer yet to be tested in this game.
There's a shot. That one's stopped by Knox. You're absolutely right. Vanderveer has not faced a lot of action down in that Toronto zone. Scrum going on behind the net here of Liz Knox as Carey Palmer will come away with it here for Brampton. Smith will poke check it away, but Ashley Riggs is right there. Ashley Riggs coming in. She'll center the puck across, but nobody was there to find it. Vicky Bendis now takes it around the net. Bendis looks out front, tries to pass in front, but Riggs was tied up with the defenseman. Molly Engstrom now trying to center it out in front for Bendis. And there's a tie-up there between Benham and Bendis. So this one's played all the way out for Toronto here. Chevry down there for Toronto. Brittany Smith will take it out here as Vicky Bendis will play it in front of her own bench back to Molly Engstrom in their own zone.
A smart play there by Vicky Bendis, not to just dump the puck into the offensive end, to bring it back to Molly Engstrom and regroup, let Brampton get a change there, and then get the puck down into their end and go to work.
Yep, very heads-up kind of play there from Vicky Bendis, as there will be a face-off here as Erica Vanderveer froze the puck in her own zone. Face-off won by Toronto by the looks of it, but now Jennifer Sadler down there for Brampton. She is taking the place of the injured Courtney Unruh, who was injured yesterday. She has a lower body injury. There's a shot in front, blocked by Toronto there, and it may have been a save as well from Vanderveer.
Great save there by Vanderveer.
So it's played all the way out, icing, waved off. Played all the way back now as Brampton will take it around behind their net. Looking to set up a play here. Plays it up. This one's picked off here at center ice as Scanzano will play it all the way back in to Brampton territory. Allie Fox now with the puck here along the sideboards. Plays the puck all the way up, trying to get it to Heppert, who was tied up. Engstrom now with the puck. And Engstrom gets her pocket picked there. Toronto takes possession of the puck as the puck goes all the way down in the corner for Allie Fox of Brampton. Hoffmeyer now plays it at the point. Hoffmeyer the shot. That one's blocked in front. Sprawling across the ice was Molly Engstrom to block the shot. Jaina Heffert now takes the puck. Heffert the shot. That one's blocked in front and cleared out there by number 12, Martine Garland. Carrie Palmer now will play the puck for Brampton as she will play the puck up for Ashley Riggs. Ashley Riggs, and that one hits the stick of Cole and will come back out.
There's no doubt here that these teams may be a little bit tired today. This is their third game in 3 days. Brampton as well playing against us out in Alberta last weekend. So they've had a lot of travel and played a lot of hockey games in the past week.
A lot of air miles going on there too.
Absolutely.
As well, going back and forth from Alberta. Scanzano trying to center the puck for Cole, but that one's picked off now as Andrea Ironside will take it. This one's played all the way up. Jillian Apps coming in. Apps the shot. That one's stopped by Vanderveer.
Vanderveer making some great saves so far in this game. Just as we were saying that she hadn't been tested at all, she's had a couple of big saves here in this game.
Brittany Smith now with the puck for Toronto in her own zone. She'll play the puck all the way up for Jesse Scanzano. Played all the way down the ice as Knox will play it around her net for Sherry Piper. Piper looking to create space there, but number 28, Brooke Beezer, is all over her. Jennifer Sadler now with the puck. Plays it for Burchard. This one's all the way down into Toronto territory as Tessa Bonhomme will take it and play it out for Beezer. Beezer trying to play it there for Mallory Deluce, but cannot find her here as Laurie Dupuy takes possession for Brampton. Dupuy the shot in front. That one's stopped by Erica Vanderveer. Toronto now takes possession here as Brittany Smith will pick it up. Plays it for Tessa Bonhomme, who will play it for Mallory Deluce. Over center ice now as Tara Gray will pick it up for Brampton. Molly Engstrom, her partner, will take possession now. All the way around the boards. Looking to create space. Toronto all over Brampton's defense right now with the puck.
Absolutely. And there's only 5 Brampton defensemen that are dressed tonight. They're going to be seeing a lot of minutes. Like I said, they're probably a little bit tired playing 3 games in 3 days. But they're doing a great job so far of getting the puck up to their forwards and getting it in deep.
And especially with their one scratch on forward, who was Jennifer Sadler, but now is a key player in their offense, Courtney Unruh, out with that lower body injury from yesterday's game. Jaina Heffert now will take control of the puck and bring it into Toronto territory, as Zamora will take and put it around the boards. Tara Gray keeps it in. Heffert trying to center it up front. There's a shot. That one's stopped by Vanderveer.
Looks like Brampton is really putting on the pressure here, pressuring the Toronto defensemen who are coughing up the puck a little bit. That'll be crucial moving forward in this game here to continue doing that and creating scoring opportunities for themselves.
About 9:35 left here in the first period. 0-0s thus far in our game here at the Gale Center for the Clarkson Cup, Game 5. Brampton now has the puck. This one's played all the way up off the stick there of number 9, that is Jennifer Bryan. So here's Liz Knox. Plays the puck all the way around. Gives it away. Here's a shot. Oh, what a save by Liz Knox! Just absolutely robbed her.
A great recovery after stepping out to play that puck behind the net. Liz Knox, I mean, she played amazing yesterday against Montreal, and she's playing amazing here again tonight.
We take another look at that. A brutal giveaway there by Liz Knox to McPhail, and gets back across to absolutely rob her with the glove. Courtney Burchard now plays it up for Andrea Ironside. I still can't get over that save by Liz Knox.
She must be pretty happy about that right now.
Save of the tournament thus far. That was unbelievable.
She may be thinking twice before stepping out to play the puck again.
Yeah, I believe so. Maybe a little bit of a mistake there on her behalf, but it was great for her to come back and recover as Jillian Apps will shoot the puck, and that one's turned aside by Erica Vanderveer. A little bit of a scrum going down, looking for possession of the puck, and that will come all the way out for Molly Engstrom. Plays it for Allie Fox. play it all the way down into the corner as Brampton will change lines here.
You talk about Liz Knox making a bit of a mistake there. That's how goals happen in this game, is players making mistakes, coughing the puck up, and whichever team seems to take the most advantage of those giveaways, of those mistakes, and scoring the goals on those opportunities, that's usually who ends up winning the hockey games.
Toronto pressing in. They took the puck away. Brooke Beezer made a nice play there off the mistake, as you mentioned, from Allie Fox. Sherry Piper now skating in. Piper the shot. That one's gloved by Erica Vanderveer, and she will hold it for a faceoff.
We were talking earlier about all of the current national team players that are out on the ice today. There's also previous national team players that have retired from the program. Sammy Joe Small, who, like we said, is not in net today. But there's also Lori Dupuy for Brampton, who has played in two Olympic games. Still an absolutely outstanding player.
The veteran of this Brampton team for sure is Lori Dupuy. As Zamora skates in, and she's checked there by Kerry Palmer. Now a scrum behind the net, and we have a whistle here. And we're going to have a penalty coming to Brampton. Kerry Palmer will get the penalty here for Brampton. She will serve 2 minutes.
Toronto here will have another opportunity.
We see the replay.
To capitalize on the power play.
Looks like a shoulder right to Zamora's chest area there. It's like a shoulder went right in. So 2 minutes for Kerry Palmer. Toronto will get their second power play of the game here as Benum tries to skate in. Zamora is slammed by Molly Engstrom along the side boards there. This one's centered out in front for Zamora. Both Zamoras, Christie and Kelly, on the ice right now for Toronto. Of course, Kelly, number 96, and Christie is number 27. McPhail now with the puck. She'll play it across. This one's played back to the point for Tessa Benum. The shot by Benum. That one's tipped in front and goes wide.
Smart play by Benum there just to get the puck through at the blue line. Doesn't have to be a big, booming slap shot. Just getting the puck through traffic on net. Rebounds will happen, and that's how the pucks go in.
And there's live boards here at the Gale Center. We've seen a lot of big bounces come off the boards. There's a wind-up. The shot stopped by Knox. The rebound loose, but now Jillian Apps will take it. Jillian Apps dumps it all the way down as there's a line change here for Brampton. Tessa Benum will play the puck now in her own zone, looking to set up some kind of play for Toronto. One's played across for Deleuze. Bryan. Jennifer Bryan now with the puck. She's going to play the puck all the way out and play it back to the point. Here's a wrist shot in front. That one's stopped by Knox. Rebound is still loose, but the whistle was blown as it looked like Knox had it frozen.
Brampton again doing an outstanding job on the penalty kill.
Yeah, Brampton really stepping up here, trying to prevent Toronto from scoring that first goal of the game and getting them behind. Here's your replay, and it looks like Liz Knox did freeze the puck. There's the whistle, and then you see the puck come loose. So there will be a faceoff here off to the right of Liz Knox, as Toronto will win the faceoff here with 25 seconds remaining in the power play. Here's a shot. That one's blocked in front. The rebound's in front. Another try, and we have a whistle, but the goal is waved off. Very, very, very quickly by the referee.
That was also a pretty quick whistle by the ref there. I'm surprised she blew it that quickly.
Yes, very shocking display there by the referee, but we have seen the referees give a lot of leeway, and they have called off about 4 or 5 goals in this tournament already, as we're going to get a quick replay just of what happened here as it hit a defenseman there trying to block the puck. The rebound's in front. There you see Bryan, and yeah, it looks like referee was a little bit too early to call that puck or call the whistle there, as Garland will take the puck now back to live action here. Deleuze now with the puck. Got about 5 minutes and 30 seconds left here as we are back to full strength as Kerry Palmer springs out of the box. Hoffmeyer the shot. That one's kicked away by a Brampton defenseman. Hoffmeyer plays the puck all the way back in for Toronto Furies. 0-0 here in game number 5 of the Clarkson Cup between Toronto and Brampton. Bowman now plays the puck. She plays it all the way across. Bryan will take it now as she is checked, and Engstrom will play it all the way back into Toronto territory. Scrum going on for the puck right there as this will finally be knocked out there by Rebecca Davies. And icing will be called on Toronto, and this will go all the way back to their end.
After another big kill there by Brampton, now they're looking to get the puck down into the Toronto end and really try to create some scoring chances for themselves. We talked about all the forwards that they have up there that can put the puck in the net. They need to start doing that here.
Definitely. Both teams need to start getting a little bit more offense going. They both seem to be playing a little bit more of a defensive kind of lax game right now. Toronto with possession of the puck over center ice now. Plays it all the way down into the corner and goes after it. Davies now trying to play the puck for Toronto, and there's another Brampton player, Ashley Riggs, in there as well. Pass all the way up. Bonhomme will take it, and looks like she's tripped up there, but no call on the play. Vanderveer now plays the puck all the way back behind the net. Francis McPhail plays the puck across for Bonhomme. This one's played all the way down the ice there by Zamora. Scanzano down there, trying to play the puck hard with Carey Palmer. Also have number 27, Christy Zamora, down there for Toronto as well. Vicky Bendis trying to get a stick in there as well. And Vicky Bendis will come away with it. So now here's Bendis to Apps, drops it for Burchard. Courtney Burchard skating and drops the puck. Bendis the shot, that one stopped. Vanderveer just got enough of that puck to knock it behind the net.
A great play there by Courtney Burchard, a defenseman, stepping up in the play. She's a defenseman with a lot of speed, a lot of skill, so I think Brampton needs to see a little bit more of that from her in this game.
Bendis now drops the puck for Apps, will forward across. Ironside the shot, one's tipped just wide by a Toronto stick now as Vicky Bendis will play the puck. Bendis the shot. Smothered by Vanderveer, and she will freeze it to slow things down and get a faceoff.
A great play there by Bendis. She's a very quick, skilled, dynamic forward. She's small, but she has the ability to really move the puck well in small spaces. She won the Patty Kazmaier Memorial Award when she was at Mercyhurst College. Just a great overall centerman for Brampton.
Vicky Bendis, we have seen a lot of in this tournament. She has been very good for Brampton, playing on a line with Jaina Hefford and Ashley Riggs. So now McPhail will take the puck. That one's shot, and that one's blocked immediately there by Allie Fox. Fox now plays the puck all the way around as Hoffmeyer will pinch in here on defense. Fox now takes the puck, and she'll play it all the way up across, and this one's stolen here. DeLuce trying to get a shot off, but she looked like she was in mid-fall as she took that shot. This one's played up as Hoffmeyer keeps the puck all the way in. Toronto doing a great job pressuring right now, and Brampton cannot get the puck out of their zone. They finally do, and this will come all the way back into their zone as it was shot in. This one's played here by Jaina Hefford. Hefford breaking in. She's got people with her. Fires a pass across. That one's knocked down by Toronto, and this will be played all the way out now. Mallory DeLuce couldn't handle the puck there, as this will go all the way back for Tessa Bonhomme. Played up. Great job there by Scanzano. Now as Brittany Smith comes in, that shot's blocked. Rebound by Scanzano, and that is stopped by Liz Knox, and she will freeze to have a faceoff.
A nice play there by Scanzano. Just to get the puck on net when you're in that close. Just to get a shot off, hoping for maybe a rebound, maybe it'll squeak in, just seeing what'll happen.
Yeah, Scanzano, very skilled player there, as you see the shot there, and Liz Knox makes the great save and freezes play here. We have a minute 45 left here in the first period. Liz Palmer will play the puck all the way around. Andrea Ironside takes it in her own zone, and she'll play it up. This is Brittany Smith. She plays across to her partner, Tessa Bonhomme. Scanzano now plays the puck up. Here's Christy Zamora. Tries to center it out in front, but
Another penalty on Brampton here.
Yep, Kelly Zamora was taken down in front of the net right there, as we will see another penalty coming as Vicky Bendis will head to the box. And the third power play coming just in this period alone for Toronto. Bendis' second penalty.
This is something that Brampton needs to be a little bit more careful of moving forward, trying to stay out of the box. You never want to give the opportunity to the other team to have the power play. That's where a lot of goals are scored in this game. So Brampton needs to maybe, you know, be more careful and more cautious of that moving forward.
Yeah, in a must-win situation like that, they cannot be taking these penalties. This one's played all the way out to center ice now as Martine Garland will take it. Played all the way down the ice here as Allie Fox will take it and try to clear it. This one stopped. McPhail coming in there, but she has the puck poked away from her. Jennifer Bryan now picks it up. This one's played all the way back. Hoffmeyer to Bryan, back to Hoffmeyer at the point. There's a shot all the way in. Here's a rebound. That one's in front, but that one's steered aside there.
You saw Courtney Burchard there in front of Liz Knox. She was basically playing a two-on-one down low, which is often the case on a power play. That defenseman in front of the net is left with a two-on-one, but she did a great job of fronting the puck and trying to keep an eye on both of those forwards in front of the net.
Jillian Apps now will play the puck all the way out. That one's off of Garland at center ice there as Hefford will take it. She is sworn by three Toronto players, so decides the smart move and just play it down the ice. 10 seconds remaining here in the first period as DeLuce skates in. DeLuce makes a nice move. Knox kicks it aside there. Hoffmeyer keeps it in. She'll play it all the way across the ice here as time will expire in the first period of play here at the Clarkson Cup, the game between Toronto and Brampton. We have a 0-0 score. What did you see in the first period that Brampton really needs to improve on?
I think first and foremost, they need to stay out of the box. You're not going to score too many goals killing penalties. So when you're in the box for 6 minutes out of 20 in one period, that's a lot. It takes away from your offense. So that's the first thing I think that they need to focus on. But overall, it's been a relatively close and even game, which is a little bit surprising considering that Brampton has won 5 out of the 6 matchups that the teams have had this season.
Yeah, it's been a very good game. We've seen a lot of great action here. Some good saves, of course, that great save by Liz Knox. So make sure you tune in to second period action here. This is Toronto versus Brampton. We got a 0-0 tie here on the Clarkson Cup here on TV Kojiko. We'll be right back. to the Gale Center here in Niagara Falls, Ontario, where we have Clarkson Cup action game number 5. We have a 0-0 score after one period here between the Toronto Furies and Brampton HC. Megan Mickelson here. What do you think of the first period overall?
Like I said, Brampton really needing to stay out of the box in the second period here. First period, relatively close hockey game, seeing some good chances from both teams, goaltenders making some outstanding saves. So hopefully Brampton can, after they kill off this penalty, create some offense, and we'll see some goals here and some excitement.
About 38 seconds left in the power play here for Toronto, as Toronto will chase this into their own zone here as Tessa Benham will take it. Benham plays it behind her net as she tries to set up a play here with about 20 seconds remaining here on the power play. Stops and tries, and she gets around one defender there, Sherry Piper, and plays it for Mallory Deluce, who will play it back for her. Brittany Smith will take it. Brittany Smith looking around, fires it, shot stopped by Liz Knox.
You saw Benham there carry the puck all the way from the defensive end into the offensive end. On the power play, when you have space and time like that and nobody is pressuring you, it's a smart play by a defenseman to carry the puck all the way into the offensive zone and set up.
Bendis the shot. That one stopped by Vanderveer. Here's a rebound. Jaina Heffer trying the rebound. A lot of traffic in front. Burchard will fire it over to Bendis. Burchard the shot. That one's blocked in front. Lots of traffic in front. A lot of bodies. Here's Burchard. Burchard will play it in. Bendis the tip. What a save by Erica Vanderveer getting across the crease. Burchard again the shot. Brampton upping the pressure here at the start of the second period.
Burchard has a great shot from the point there. I was mentioning earlier that we need to see a little bit more offense from her, and she's definitely doing that here, getting the pucks through the traffic and to the net.
Yep, Burchard, of course, we mentioned at the top of the broadcast, she is the Rookie of the Year here at the CWHL, and she will be attending Team Canada tryouts there as there's a shot, and that was turned aside there by Liz Knox. Hoffmeyer will play this puck all the way in, and that one's knocked down. Zamora will play it out. Play it all the way back across, but that one's picked off there by Carrie Palmer. Up the boards now here as Brampton will play the puck all the way out and into Toronto territory as Vanderveer will take it and play it off for Hoffmeyer. Zamora now plays the puck up for the other Zamora. Christy and Kelly Zamora. Now here's Molly Engstrom. Engstrom now will take the puck and play it across. Hoffmeyer will take it and play it all the way up. This one's played back now by Engstrom. Engstrom across to Allison Fox. This one's played all the way up here as Vicky Bendis will take the possession of the puck and bring it deep into Toronto territory. Fumbling my words there, excuse me. Here's Engstrom who plays it across. Fox the shot. That one's tipped and just high of the net. McPhail will take the puck now. Played all the way across here. Bendis takes it away. Bendis breaking and she's got Apps with her. Bendis the shot. That one's tipped in front but just wide. Ironside plays the puck out. Tries to center in front for Apps. But that one's played by Toronto. Scrum going on as Brampton trying to get the puck.
Looks like we're going to have a call for too many men on the ice for Brampton here. There's a little bit of a mix-up on the line change there, so it looks like they'll be going on the penalty kill yet again.
And Judy Cates, the coach here of Brampton, does not seem happy about this too many men call.
Well, there were certainly too many men on the ice there. You could clearly see that there was 6 Brampton players. I think they were a little bit confused as to who was jumping off and who was jumping on.
Lori Dupuy is going to serve the penalty here for Brampton for the too many men call. And Toronto will be back on the power play. And you mentioned that Brampton needs to stay out of the box. They're not doing a good job of this right now.
Absolutely. In the same breath, though, Toronto, they've had, you know, this is their 4th power play opportunity. They're getting the chances. They need to start capitalizing on the power play opportunities.
Tessa Benham fakes the shot, passes across. Smith the shot. That one goes just wide. played out here as Tessa Benham will take it at the point and play it back. This one's over for Brittany Smith. To Benham, fakes the shot, passes it back to Smith at the point. Shot by Benham. There's a shot tip just wide. Jillian Apps trying to get it out, but she's checked by DeLome. Sorry, DeLuce. This one's played all the way down to the ice to Erica Vanderveer, the goalie for Toronto, who will play it out the center for Mallory DeLuce. Played all the way up here as this will hit the skate of Jaina Hefford, who has almost sprung free here, as Zamora will take this one now. Hefford now plays this one all the way out to center ice now as it's knocked down there. Great job there by the defense, Brittany Smith. And we have a collision between two Toronto players as there is an offside call.
Brampton certainly doing a great job again here of killing the penalty. Not a situation that you want to be in, but you know, after killing off a penalty, often that's when it gives your team that momentum moving forward. So Brampton, like I said, doing a great job.
Scanzano will take the puck now as we're going to have a delayed call here. It's going to be a interference call here as it looks like it's going to be number 67, Rebecca Davies, heading to the box here for Toronto.
So we'll be 4-on-4 here now for 53 seconds. As a player, this is one of my favorite situations to play in, playing 4-on-4. It creates a little bit more space, a little bit more time to carry the puck, and one of the key factors in playing 4-on-4 is keeping possession of the puck. So when you have it, you never want to give it away to the other team, no matter where you have it on the ice. So we'll see which team can do a better job of that here.
Now we got a little bit of a delay here as Judy Cates trying to figure out who she's going to put on the ice where, as looks like Jaina Hefford will be out on the ice here for Brampton, right in front of the bench. Face-off won by Piper, and Hefford switches off for Engstrom very fast off the draw. Here's Courtney Burchard. Plays it back for Engstrom. Engstrom looking around, trying to find someone. Plays the puck deep now into Toronto territory. And just as you said, Megan, Brampton keeping possession of the puck right now here on this 4-on-4. Here's a shot! Engstrom fans on that shot as it goes down low here as Apps will take it. Apps trying to get around a lot of players here. Burchard plays it back. Here's a shot by Piper. That one's knocked aside by Vanderveer.
Have some big shooters out on the ice for Brampton right now. Sherry Piper has a great shot along with Burchard and Engstrom. And, of course, Jillian Apps, who is Brampton's leading scorer this year with 39 points.
Jillian Apps, of course, on Team Canada as well. You know a lot about her, Megan.
Absolutely. She's now played in two Olympics. She's actually been on the national team since 2001, but, you know, a big body out on the ice, but she has speed. She also has skill and can really fire the puck. As a defenseman, she's a tough player to defend. She'll park herself right in front of the other team's goalie, and she's a tough player to move.
And, of course, she also is related to Syl Apps, former Toronto Maple Leaf great, which some great lineage dating back there in her family for hockey.
Yeah, hockey's definitely in the genes there.
So now this one is won by Toronto.
You saw a quick fake there by Brittany Smith to wrap it around the boards and then brought it back and shook off that forechecker.
That was a smart play there by Brittany Smith as Arts is now there for Toronto. Here's Bendis, who will play it all the way across now. Carrie Palmer now coming in. The defenseman breaking in, pinching in on offense as she gets tangled up with the referee there. And this one will go all the way out and back to center. 28 seconds remaining here in the power play for the Brampton HC Club, who are looking to get ahead in this game. It's been very evenly matched thus far. Fired all the way down the ice there by Toronto as Liz Knox will take it and play it back behind her net for Courtney Burchard. Molly Engstrom now takes it with about 6 seconds remaining here in the power play.
You see Burchard and Engstrom, they've gotten a lot of minutes so far in this game, and I think that as the game goes on, they'll continue to see more ice time.
We got a huge collision down in the Toronto area there as Jillian Apps just laid out goaltender Erica Vanderveer, who was playing the puck. Apps, of course, only in her second game back from a suspension almost just like this for the charging call. And there you see right here on the replay, Apps coming in. Vanderveer trying to play the puck, and Apps just goes right into her. Big collision there. A big hit by Apps. Luckily, Vanderveer is okay. Trainer checking on her right now, but it looks like she's a little bit shaken, but she will probably stay in this game.
And that looked relatively unintentional. You could see on the replay there that Jillian Apps was going for the puck first. She went in stick first. Collisions like that happen in the game of hockey, like you said, though, and we're going to get another look here. And you'll see Jillian Apps going in. She'll go in with her stick first, trying to get that puck, and then the collision occurs. So, like I said, you know, that happens in the game of hockey. Women's hockey, even though there isn't the full-on body contact, it still is a very, very physical game.
Yeah, and there you see Zamora helping the trainer off there as she was checking on Vanderveer, who looks to be okay as she is still remaining in the net. We have a penalty here for Jillian Apps, though, for 2 minutes. Of course, the goaltender interference call, I'm assuming it's going to be called on. So Toronto back on the power play here. They have not taken advantage of it yet. Brittany Smith now will play the puck across from Mallory Deluce, who cannot play it. Chevry will knock down a defender here as this will be played all the way back to the point. Smith, the shot! That one's tipped and just high of the net. Corey Chevry trying to tip the puck in front off that shot by Brittany Smith. Bonhomme now. Tessa Bonhomme looking for someone to... Here's a shot. That one's tipped in front. Rebound. There's a shot. Liz Knox gets a piece of that one.
Great patience at the blue there by Bonhomme. And then just tossing it through traffic. You don't need to always get that big booming slap shot through. As long as the puck gets through the front of the net, there will be rebounds. Get the forwards on the pucks there, and that's how they go in.
So here's Brittany Smith, Bonhomme looking for another shot, trying to get it in front. This one's played now, and Bonhomme will take it back at the point. She'll play it back across for Brooke Beezer. Played across, Brittany Smith winds up Bonhomme, the shot. That one's tipped just high. Played in front, Beezer, the shot. That one stopped by Liz Knox, but that one will be taken wide. Fired all the way down the ice there by Vicky Bendis, who gets it out of danger. As 44 seconds will remain here on the penalty to Jillian Apps. Tessa Bonhomme now will take the puck and she'll play it all the way up for Martine Garland. Garland plays it across. This is Christy Zamora, excuse me. Zamora the shot. That one's easily stopped by Liz Knox as the net will come off. And we will have a faceoff in Brampton territory.
Toronto really needs to start taking advantage of their power play opportunities here. Being this close of a game, you know, getting those chances, getting those opportunities, and capitalizing on them, that's what can make the difference at the end of this game when there's 1 or 2 minutes left and it's this tight. So they really need to start putting the puck in the net.
Yeah, and Brampton really trying to press forward, but they keep getting those penalties, which have been costing them on offense. Toronto now taking the puck here. Scanzano will play the puck all the way back across. This one's played up now. All the way down deep in the Brampton territory as Allie Fox would play it out, but that one stopped and kept in Toronto's zone. And here is Martine Garland called for the puck but couldn't handle the pass there. Scanzano holding the puck in the corner now for Toronto. Played all the way back for Zamora. Scanzano battling now down low with Courtney Burchard in the corner. Christy Zamora now helping out as Scanzano will take the puck, trying to center it out in front. Someone's played all the way around here as Jillian Apps will take it. Apps skating in. Here's a shot stopped by Vanderveer. The rebound pops up and over Jaina Hefford's stick.
Smart play by Apps there, coming up the wall. She wasn't going to beat that defenseman one-on-one, but just getting the puck through. The Toronto defenseman sort of serving as a bit of a screen there. Just throwing the puck on net by Jillian Apps. Smart play there.
We have about 10:56 remaining here in the second period. Still no score. It's been a very evenly matched game between Brampton HC and Toronto here at the Clarkston Club. Clarkson Cup, excuse me. Toronto will take possession in their own zone and play the puck all the way out to center ice here, where Carrie Palmer for Brampton will take it. Jillian Abbs battling inside, and she gets laid right out. Wow, what a big hit there by Kelly Zamora, number 96 for Toronto, as Jillian Abbs may have just got her revenge hit from hitting the goaltender Erica Vanderveer earlier. So here's Kelly Zamora going to the box for Toronto. There you see the hit right here as she comes right in, head down a little bit, and just battling for the puck, and she takes Apps right off her feet.
You see Jillian Apps go down there, but she gets right back up and shows some good discipline. She could have gone right back after Zamora there. I know if that would have been me, you know, I would have been a little bit fired up after getting hit like that. So some good discipline there, so that Brampton now on the power play and will get a good shot here to get a goal.
Yep, Brampton now first power play of the, or excuse me, second power play of the game for them, as they're looking to capitalize on the man advantage here. This one's played across out in front. That one's blocked before it hit goaltender Vanderveer. Great steal there by Engstrom, but that one is still going to be played out as Sherry Piper will take it for the Brampton HC club.
The Brampton power play here, Hefford, Apps, Engstrom, Piper, Burchard, all five national team players, four Canadians and one American. So it's a pretty stacked power play here.
Burchard now takes the puck. You're absolutely right, by the way, on that one. It's very, very stacked power play that Brampton shows great depth as well. Here's Sherry Piper. This one's blocked in front, and this one's going to be sprung now. Here comes Toronto. There's a shot stopped by Liz Knox on the breakaway. Great job there by Brooke Beezer to take the puck away off the turnover and get a great breakaway chance, but Liz Knox turns her aside.
A tough play there by Sherry Piper. Those are plays you have to be careful with the puck at the blue line. Trying to beat a player one-on-one when you're the last man back, there's a high chance of a turnover there.
Yep, you're absolutely right on that one. Sherry Piper a little bit careless with the puck right there, and Brooke Beezer took advantage. But luckily, Liz Knox was there to turn Beezer aside and keep this game 0-0. So now here's Bendis. Vicky Bendis coming in with speed, fighting off Toronto defenders, and she'll play this one all the way back for Laurie Dupuis. Knox plays the puck. And 2 minutes and 30 seconds left on the power play. It looks like we had a double minor there on Kelly Zamora for that hit on Apps. Rebecca Davies plays the puck all the way across. Here's a backhand try by Mallory Deluce, but she cannot find the net.
Brampton being a little bit careless with the puck here. They've now had two turnovers on this power play.
Ashley Riggs now trying to play the puck out, and this will go all the way back out to center ice now as Courtney Burchard will take it and play it for Allison Fox. Ashley Riggs now taking the puck with speed coming over to blue line. Plays that one all the way down as Garland will take it. Garland gets it out. Nope, she will not. Sherry Piper right there to knock it down, but now it gets out as we have a little bit of a collision going on there between Jennifer Bryan.
We'll get another penalty call here.
Now Jennifer Bryan, Jaina Hefford with a little bit of a mix-up there as they bumped into the linesman as well. So we will have another penalty here as Jaina Hefford will go to the box for Brampton. 2 minutes for holding. So Jaina Hefford, of course, team captain of Brampton as well as a member of the National Team Canada.
Jaina Hefford is a four-time Olympian. She's been on the national team since 1997.
Which is a very, very long time as well. She's been there just as long as Haley Wickenheiser as well.
Yeah, and she's not losing her step at all. In fact, I think over the course of the year, she just keeps getting better and better and faster, it seems.
Smith the shot. This is a rebound in front. And Knox is getting hampered with shots down there. And she manages to keep the puck out of the net. Great job there by Liz Knox. Toronto putting the pressure on this power play. And there you see right there, you have a couple players in front for Toronto finding the puck. Finally gets on the stick, the shot, and Liz Knox saves it back to live action here with a 4-on-4 for both teams.
I believe that was Molly Engstrom in front of the net there on defense for Brampton that did a great job.
Jillian Apps will take the puck. Here comes Jillian Apps. Here's a shot blocker save made by Erica Vanderveer as Apps dives right over top of her trying to get the rebound. Toronto now takes the puck, bringing it all the way back around here as McPhail made a nice play. Vicky Bendis now takes the puck. She'll center in front for Engstrom. Engstrom to Burchard. Burchard the shot. Kick save. Rebound scores! Molly Engstrom puts Brampton on the board. 1-0 with a great rebound goal. Molly Engstrom, of course, on Team USA. She's a defenseman pitching in there on offense on the 4-on-4 as we'll take another good look at this one.
You see Courtney Burchard there taking that shot, not necessarily shooting to score, but shooting for a rebound, and it pops right out to Molly Engstrom, who has plenty of time to put the puck right up top.
Great goal there for Molly Engstrom, first of the tournament here, as faceoff won by Toronto. 7:20 left here in the second period. We have a 1-0 score for Brampton, thanks to that goal there that you just seen by Molly Engstrom. This one's played all the way around deep into Brampton territory as there will be an icing call here on Toronto, and this will go back to Toronto territory. We've seen a great game here thus far. Fans really getting treated here with an evenly matched game.
Toronto looking a little bit deflated right now. It seems like Brampton is starting to take over, gaining some momentum in the second period here.
Absolutely, and Brampton's really trying to make Toronto looks like backpedal on defense and make sure that they have possession of the puck at all times. Scanzano now for Toronto here. She'll take the puck all the way across her own blue line, play it up, puck all the way up. This one's tipped out there by Carey Palmer, who makes a good play diving to try to get the puck out. This one hits the skate of Lori Dupuy as Scanzano will take possession of the puck again. Scanzano coming in. Here's the shot. Big blocker save made there by Liz Knox. This one's played back across. Here's another shot. That one's stopped and up into the netting as we will have another faceoff. The shots right now are 17-14 in favor of Brampton. So Toronto's still hanging in there.
Absolutely. And now they're on the power play here for just 15 seconds. But, I mean, that's 15 seconds of a chance. You're outmanning the other team. They win this draw here and could get a good scoring opportunity. But Deluce loses it.
Nice play on words on that one, Megan. As this one goes all the way back for Toronto as they will play it behind their own net. Mallory Deluce. Jaina Hefford comes right out of the box and checks her. Here's Deluce. We're back to even strength here on the ice as Jaina Hefford will play the puck. Andrea Ironside looking to get it, but she cannot. And this one's tipped up into the bench and almost knocks the trainer out. So a great job there by Brampton. Jaina Hefford coming right out of the box and checking Mallory Deluce off the puck. How effective has Jaina Hefford been this game?
Jaina Hefford, I think Brampton might be looking for a little bit more from her. She's an extremely fast forward and can really create some great offensive scoring opportunities. So I think overall from Brampton, we need to see more offense here.
So Brampton ahead 1-0 here in this game, but Toronto really starting to press here as Megan Arts will take the shot. Turned aside there by Liz Knox in the corner. McPhail will take it. Jennifer Bryan now looking for space as Vicky Bendis is all over her. This one's passed across. Here's a shot in front. Tipped rebound. And that one goes out as Andrea Ironside will take the puck and play this all the way back.
A great play there by Callison just to get the puck through traffic and on net.
Matt Haley Callison made a great play to get the puck in, but Brampton now has possession. Here's Burchard. Courtney Burchard bringing the puck all the way back to the point. Engstrom, the goal scorer here in the second period. This one's played all the way back around here. Scrum down near the blue line here as Megan Arts will take possession of the puck. Played up now as Scanzano will have the puck. Zamora back to Scanzano, and Toronto just looking for time to get the puck into Brampton territory. This one's taken now. Great job there by Lori Dupuy. This one's played back here as Tessa Bonhomme will take the puck. Carrie Palmer now coming, or sorry, that was Jennifer Sadler coming in to take the puck away. All the way down the ice here as Liz Knox will play it in her own zone all the way out. This one's taken now by Sherry Piper. Sherry Piper breaking in. Here's the shot turned aside by Erica Vanderveer. This one's played all the way across the blue line. Here's Hefford. Jaina Hefford breaking in. Here's a shot. Great save made by Vanderveer. Erica Vanderveer playing very well thus far in the game. So right now we're looking at another faceoff here as Erica Vanderveer made a great save and froze the puck. Jaina Hefford here with the shot. You see Vanderveer making a great save for Toronto to keep them in this game. It's only 1-0, so they have a lot of time to come back. Knox makes the save, and we'll have yet another faceoff.
We're seeing Toronto here trying to create some offense. Deluce just trying to get the puck on net there, seeing what can happen. You never know sometimes when you just throw the puck on net.
Here's a shot. Knox stops it, and we will have yet another faceoff. Shots now 19-16 in favor of Brampton. Have a great game going on here. Game 5 of the Clarkson Cup. If you're just joining us here on TV Kojiko, the score is 1-0. We have 4:02 remaining in the second period. Brampton HC on top of Toronto.
A good face-off win there by Vicky Bendis.
This one's played back to the point as Brittany Smith will take it. All the way back around, trying to center it in front. Mallory Deluce is in on that one. Knox lost her stick, and we had a little bit of aggression there at the end of the play as Mallory Deluce looks like she got involved with a little bit of a scrap kind of deal there.
Deluce, not a big player in terms of size, but she definitely can be pretty feisty. We're seeing that there.
Yeah, she's seen that right there, as you said, knocking down one of the Brampton players. Looked like Carrie Palmer that she got into it with there at the end of the play there.
Deluce, I'm a big fan of hers. As we mentioned earlier, she's a member of the Canadian national team. She also played at the University of Wisconsin, where she won 2 NCAA national championships. I was also at the University of Wisconsin, so I have a bit of a soft spot for Mel.
She was a former teammate as well, right?
Not at the University of Wisconsin. I graduated before she got there, but, you know, they say once a Badger, always a Badger. So
yeah, absolutely.
I'm always cheering for them still.
Absolutely, a Badger sisterhood on that part, right? So coming in now with the puck is Brampton, Jaina Hefford. Shot, nope, rebound is going in front as she gets ran into the post. Vanderveer avoiding yet another collision. Jillian Apps plays the puck back around as Tessa Benum will take it. Courtney Burchard keeping the puck all the way in. You have Hefford here behind the net. Molly Engstrom back to Piper at the point. Piper normally a forward playing defensive point right now as Engstrom and Burchard are on the sides. Now what kind of setup is that they have going on right now where they have a forward at the top of the point and they have the two defense on the side?
You see a lot of teams do that oftentimes. They'll throw one of their forwards back on defense. The U.S. national team, I know they do that with Monique Lamoureux. And you see that with Sherry Piper.
Rebound scores! Sorry to cut you up there, Megan,
That's
but
okay.
Vicky Bendis pounces on a big rebound there and puts Brampton ahead 2-0. Erica Vanderveer could not hold on to that puck that she made a glove save on, and Vicky Bendis wasted no time capitalizing on that to put Brampton up 2-0.
Vicky Bendis, a small but a relentless forward, always going after the rebounds, and she does just that on her own shot and puts the puck away.
Yeah, great job there by Vicky Bendis. We have 2:25 remaining here in the second period at the Gale Center, and Brampton on top of Toronto 2-0 now thanks to a goal there by Vicky Bendis. Ashley Riggs now centers it in front. Shot scores! Another goal by Brampton, and they are now up 3-0 on Toronto. What a great passing play right there
You can really see it now in the body language of the Toronto players that they're getting a bit deflated here. That last goal by Bendis and now this goal here is a huge turning point in this game.
Laurie Dupuy finishing that great passing play off here for Brampton as they are now out in front 3-0. I have a quick replay of this one. And there's the shot right there off of the goaltender and in. So 3-0 now, the score. Brampton up on Toronto as Callison has trouble with the puck right there. Zamora plays the puck all the way up. Knox plays the puck out now for Carey Palmer. Courtney Burchard behind her own net. Burchard plays it all the way up. This is Sadler. She'll play the puck up. And this one's tipped all the way in. Brittany Salina trying to get control of it for Brampton. Tried to be played out there by Toronto as we have both Zamoras as well as Sadler and Palmer in there on that one. And we have a whistle. Not sure exactly what for. Maybe referee lost sight of the puck in that little scrum right there.
That last goal by Brampton there, just a comment. It wasn't a big booming shot right along the ice. Got through traffic, got by the goalie. All three goals that we've seen by Brampton, they're not big booming shots, which you don't see too much of in women's hockey. We just can't seem to shoot the puck as hard as the men. And a lot of the goals coming from either rebounds or quick plays off the side of the net.
So now Haley Callison will play the puck all the way up. Megan Arts trying to get it out, but she cannot. Vicky Bendis is right there, but now Toronto's sprung free. Here's Megan Arts. Takes the shot that's off the stick of Allison Fox and goes to Molly Engstrom's stick for Brampton. She will get the puck all the way out as Tessa Benham will take it. Plays it all the way around the net here as Liz Knox will take it and play it for Engstrom. Ironside will take it now as we have 1 minute left here in the second period with Brampton on top, 3-0.
We have Benham and Brittany Smith there on the back end for Toronto. Guaranteed in a 3-0 hockey game, we're going to be seeing a lot more of them. They're two of Toronto's top defensemen.
Ironside will play the puck all the way back around as it looks like that number 7, Mallory Deluce, will play back for Benham. Excuse me. So now here's Deluce. Brittany Smith now takes the puck.
Brampton really starting to put the pressure on Toronto here.
Tessa Benham will play the puck all the way back up. Corey Chevery, trying to play the puck all the way back across, misses the stick. This one goes all the way out. And now Jaina Hefford will take possession of the puck. She plays this up for Ashley Riggs. Coming in, the shot, stopped, rebound, what a save, rebound again. And Erica Vanderveer somehow keeping that out of the net as time expires here in the second period of play. And looks like Vanderveer is a little shaken up on that play.
A great save there by Vanderveer.
Absolutely. She got across the crease and absolutely robbed Jaina Hefford and Ashley Riggs on those two shots. But at the end of this third period, it's a score of 3-0. Let's take another look there. Ashley Riggs, the shot. And you have a great save made by
Riggs there. Vanderveer. That was a good shot on net, but that also was a 3-on-1 for Brampton there. When you have an odd man rush like that, sometimes you want to look for the pass as well.
Vanderveer's a little slow skating off the ice there, as you've seen, but you did see the replay there. She robbed Riggs, and then she got Brittany Salina as well. So 3-0 here at the end of the second period. What did you see from Toronto that they have to improve on going into the third?
Toronto, it seemed like they lost a lot of their momentum in that period, and I think we started to see Brampton really take over probably about 5 minutes into that second period. And towards the end there, you could just tell Brampton really putting the pressure on after scoring those two goals. I think it gave them, you know, a lot of momentum and a lot of confidence as well.
So we will see how the third period and the rest of the game will play out here as we go into the second intermission with the score 3-0 Brampton over the Toronto Furies. Keep watching Clarkson Cup action here on TV Kojiko. We have the Clarkson Cup here. We're ready for third period action here of Game 5 between Toronto Furies and the Brampton HC Club. Look at the scoring summary from the second period. Of course, Molly Engstrom kicked it off at 12:37. We also had Vicky Bendis and Allie Fox chime in with a couple goals there to put Brampton ahead 3-0.
And Brampton really taking control of this game in the second half of that second period. These first 5 minutes will be really crucial for Toronto. Even 10 minutes, they need to get a goal or two here.
As the third period is underway now, as Carrie Palmer will play the puck here for Brampton. Coming up the ice now on the side here, that looks like Jennifer Sadler. She's going to center a puck out. Heffer trying to center it right back. No, that's Brittany Salinas. Sorry. This one comes all the way back here as Beezer will take the puck now. She tries to drop it for Chevery, but that one is picked off here as Brittany Salina will take the puck and skate up ice. Plays it all the way down as Brampton will make the change. Brittany Smith now takes the puck for Toronto as she will play the puck all the way up over center ice trying to find Scanzano. Great job here by Zamora trying to get in here. Back to Bonhomme, all the way up for Scanzano. Looking across the ice, she'll play it off the boards all the way for Zamora. Christy and Kelly Zamora for Toronto here. This is Andrea Ironside now. Ironside breaking in. She'll leave the puck for Bendis, but that one's knocked away by Kelly Zamora.
Toronto forward Zamora, they're doing a good job of coming back, supporting the defenseman, back checking through the middle of the ice.
Bendis now will play the puck here in Toronto zone, but that was a great job there by number 11, Amy Jack. Sorry, that was number 12, Martine Garland. My bad on that one. This one's a shot stopped by Vanderveer. Piper will play the puck all the way back to the point here for Engstrom. Molly Engstrom looking around, trying to find an opening here. Plays the puck in the middle, and that one's just wide here as Allie Fox will take it.
Brampton really taking control over this game right now. Toronto scrambling a bit in their own end, but luckily they get it out and have the opportunity to get a change here. All in all, to be icing, so there will be no change.
Nope, no change there for either team. So we will have an icing call, and this will go all the way back to Toronto territory. Now, Toronto needs to really capitalize on some advantages. Of course, the penalties that have been taken by Brampton. What do they need to do the most to capitalize on these penalties?
Absolutely, and those five power plays that Toronto had earlier on in the game, now moving into the third period here, down three goals, those are chances that they needed to capitalize on earlier in the game that would have made a huge difference here moving into the third period.
Yes, absolutely. As Toronto trying to make sure that they get some more shots on net as well, that way they create better opportunities for themselves.
Absolutely, but Brampton has done a good job in the first 2 minutes of this period of really pressuring Toronto.
Here's Carrie Palmer, who will play the puck all the way down for Brittany Salina. Salina plays it back to the point. Tara Gray now going to put the puck all the way in. Toronto plays the puck all the way back out, and this will be for Megan Arts.
Jesse Scanzano, one of Toronto's top forwards, doing a really good job of forechecking there. As a defenseman, when you have a forward of that size coming down, knowing that you have them pressuring you, putting that pressure on you, it's tough to make a play in that situation.
McPhail now with the puck for Toronto. She's going to get around the diving Carrie Palmer. There's a shot. Knox will knock it aside. Stepping up there was Bowman for Toronto. And Ashley Riggs trying to pick the pocket there, but she cannot. Bowman now takes the puck. There's a shot. That one's blocked in front before it gets to the net. This one's played all the way back out. Megan Arts, the shot. There's a shot. That one's very much stopped by Liz Knox, who got across the crease and made an easy save.
Some good plays by Toronto there, trying to turn the momentum around in this hockey game. Playing the first 2 minutes in their own end. Now they've been down in the Brampton end. A good shot there from the point.
This one's won by Toronto as Callison will shoot it. That one's blocked in front before it got through. Davies will play the puck back around here. Mallory DeLuce will try to play the puck back. She will for Bowman. There's a shot. That one goes just wide as we have a glove on the ice. Not sure whose. This one's played all the way down behind the net. Bendis will take the puck now. Plays it across for Jillian Apps. And easy save made by Vanderveer as we will have a faceoff.
We saw a spurt there from Toronto where they seem to be playing with a little bit more of a sense of urgency. They know that, you know, with 16 and a half minutes left in this hockey game, this could very well be their season. So they really need to start playing with more urgency like we just saw in that last minute and a half.
Yeah, Toronto really trying to step up and, you know, get the best of their make the best of their opportunities that they have to get themselves back in this game.
Brittany Smith doing a great job there of jumping up in the play for Toronto. She played at St. Lawrence University and was a member of the national team program a couple years ago.
So Brittany Smith, of course, has that a little bit more of that experience and that high-level kind of play to credit with her partner, Tessa Benham.
And I think moving forward in this third period, we're going to be seeing a lot of Brittany Smith and Tessa Benham.
Molly Engstrom will take the puck. That one's blocked there in front by Corey Chevry. Played all the way back out, but knocked down by Dupuis. Here's Sherry Piper, but that one's knocked away by McPhail, who cannot find it, but now does, as Laurie Dupuis is hot on her trail. Brittany Smith will play it for Benham. Chevry now with the puck, and she's checked up against the boards as Jaina Hefford will take it. Puts it around Benham and around the net as Brittany Smith will take control of it for Toronto. Flips the puck all the way out the center. This one's gloved and put back down on the ice there by Molly Engstrom. Ashley Riggs now with the puck. Riggs skating in. Riggs trying to play the puck back to the point. Palmer to Engstrom. Engstrom the shot. That one goes just wide. In the corner now, Tessa Benham battling. She'll play it back for Scanzano. Jess Scanzano is checked there. She falls over the blue line. Tessa Benham now looking for an opening. Ashley Riggs hot on her trail as Brittany Smith will now take the puck. Zamora trying to play it up as Scanzano will take it into Brampton territory. There's a shot trying to get it in front for Kelly Zamora, but cannot.
A good centering play there by Scanzano.
Christy Zamora now with the puck as she is checked there as Vicky Bendis will take over for Brampton. Plays it up for Jillian Apps. Jillian Apps drops it for Bendis. Plays it back across. Here's a shot. That one's blocked in front. Lots of traffic in front before that shot can come off the stick. So here's Scanzano. Plays the puck all the way up as Liz Knox will knock it aside. Courtney Burchard plays it for Brampton. Back to Vicky Bendis, who plays it up for Apps. Apps skates over center ice. Plays the puck all the way deep into Toronto territory. Toronto looking now to set up a play here. Number 12, the defenseman.
I believe that's Martine Garland that just had the puck. She played at the University of New Hampshire and also played on the under-22 national team for a number of years. I had the opportunity to play with her. She also played over in Switzerland, actually, in a female elite league over there. So another defenseman on Toronto with a lot of experience.
Veteran defenseman there, Martine Garland. So now Toronto has an opportunity, but Brampton has kept the pressure up in this period on Toronto's defense. Molly Engstrom breaking in, drops it back. Brittany Salina, she has her pocket pick there, and this will be played all the way out. Good job there by Toronto. Bowman now takes the puck. This one's played all the way back around. Riggs can't handle it. Chevry will keep it in for Toronto. Molly Engstrom now with the puck. She's checked off of it. Mallory DeLuce now looking for someone. She finds Bowman. There's a shot. That one's tipped and goes just high of the net. Ashley Riggs now takes the puck for Brampton. She plays the puck all the way up. In comes Brampton. Here's the shot. That one stopped. It goes off the side of the net. And then into the net very, very hard there is Jennifer Sadler.
It was a great shift there for Mallory DeLuce. She carried the puck into the offensive end and showed some great poise and patience carrying the puck in there around the net. We'll see one of the Brampton players come in here trying to drive the puck to the net.
she ends up getting tripped up there and crashes into the side of the net after the puck was stopped there by Vanderveer. And that was Brittany Salina for Brampton. Scanzano trying to come in, and she is checked there. Bowman now plays the puck. This one will be stopped there. Zamora now with control of the puck. Christy Zamora plays it back around for Scanzano. Scanzano's checked hard there into the boards, and she gets right back up.
As I mentioned earlier, Toronto playing with a little more sense of urgency here.
There's a shot! Scores! Right on the doorstep there was Christy Zamora, and she puts Toronto on the board here in the third period with 11:57 left, as Christy Zamora will get the goal here past Liz Knox to make the game 3-1.
A great job there by Toronto, working the puck around the perimeter. And like I said, in the past 5 or 6 minutes here, Toronto started to play with a lot more of a sense of urgency, and it really pays off there.
You see the shot from the point, and it goes right off the pad and right onto the stick of Christy Zamora, who puts Toronto on the board.
And again, the defenseman there from the point, just getting that shot through. Doesn't have to be a big booming slap shot, wrister from the point. Keep it close to the ice, the rebounds will pop out, and we see a goal there that results from it.
So a 3-1 game now, as Toronto's starting to get momentum back as Christy Zamora tickles the twine here in the third period. Toronto the shot, and great save by Liz Knox as she gets hit there at the end of the play by Frances McPhail.
It'll be crucial here for Toronto, after scoring that goal, to really keep the pressure on Brampton, making sure in the offensive end, again, working the puck around the perimeter and really pressuring their defensemen.
Toronto now trying to keep their momentum up as Benham will pass across to Smith. Smith has that goal off of Piper, and Brampton will take control of it. Lori Dupuy now trying to control the puck into her own zone. She bumps into Piper. Piper, the shot. That one stopped. The rebound's in front of the net loose, but Jennifer Sadler could not corral it.
That's something that you never want to see, is Sherry Piper in the slot with the puck.
Here's
She's
another
got a great shot.
Toronto breaking in here. There's a rebound. Scores! Brittany Smith capitalizes on that big rebound, and all of a sudden it's 3-2.
Toronto really turning this game around here.
And a great job there by Brittany Smith on defense to come right in on the play. Crash the net hard, and she gets a great rebound that ends up on her stick. And you see it right here. The shot stopped by the stick. Big rebound out in front. Nobody can corral it. Brittany Smith takes it, and she puts it top shelf where Dad hides the whiskey.
They say that a two-goal lead is the worst lead to have in hockey. And now Brampton will take a timeout here to regroup a bit, as Toronto has seemed to really turn the momentum around in this game.
Yeah, Jody Cates making sure that her team is all calmed down now, making sure that her team knows what they're going to do here in the last, basically we have about 10 minutes left here in the period. And it's going to be a long period now for Brampton now that their momentum is gone.
Absolutely. But, I mean, they'll take the time out here, regroup. And sometimes that's just what you need as a team, is just, you know, a minute here just to refocus, regroup, say, hey, you know what, there's 11 minutes left in this game. We still have the lead. But whoever scores the next goal here, it's definitely a big one.
Yeah, it's going to be a huge momentum shift if Toronto can get another one here. Brampton's defense needs to step up and try to stop Toronto's momentum right now. Played all the way down in the corner here behind the net as Selena will play it for Tara Gray. Ashley Riggs now takes the puck as she plays it up for Jaina Hefford. Hefford skates by Hofmeyer into the corner and will play the puck. Garland now battling with Hefford.
I was just going to say, Ashley Riggs, also a former member of the Canadian national team. She actually was centralized and tried out for the 2006 Olympic team and was one of the last forwards cut.
Which is an interesting fact there, too. Now, do you know if she'll be coming back to try out?
I think that she has finished her career as a national team player. In my opinion, she could still be there. She's very skilled, very quick, very fast. She's definitely a tough forward to defend against. So I'm not sure if that's one of her goals or not, but in my opinion, she could be there.
We have a face-off now after Liz Knox made a great save there on Mallory Deluce. Scenario here is Brampton with control of the puck. Courtney Burchard misplays it as this will be knocked out by Callison. This one's up now for Scanzano, and Scanzano is tripped there by the looks of it. And we're going to have a delayed call here. Looks like we're going to have another penalty.
Nope, just an offside call there, I think.
Offsides. Yeah, offside on Toronto, so we're going to have a face-off just outside of the Brampton zone. This one's up. Here's Bowman. Bowman will play that in. Knox can't handle the rebound there, but luckily for her, Carey Palmer was right there before Scanzano got on it. Here's Christy Zamora. Palmer takes it away. Here's Kelly Zamora. This one's played out. There's a shot. That one's blocked by Burchard's stick. So now Brampton will take control as Bendis will play it for Ironside. This one's up as Callison plays it right back into Brampton territory.
Knox looking a little bit shaky in this third period. She needs to get back to where she was in the first.
And second. She was great in the second period as well. So now Brampton really needs to start controlling the puck better and making sure that Toronto does not get another one here.
Absolutely, and that was probably one of the key messages that the Brampton coach portrayed to those players when she called that timeout, is just, you know, calm it down. Let's get back to our game, which is a solid puck-moving game.
Sherry Piper now with the puck. She'll play this one out for Allison Fox, excuse me. Jennifer Bryan now with the puck, and she'll play the puck all the way up the boards. Engstrom tries to hold it in, but she cannot. Toronto comes away with the puck now. This is Tessa Benham. Tessa Benham skating in from the defense, and there's a nice stop there by Liz Knox, trying to keep her Brampton team in this game as best as she can.
I have to mention there, Molly Engstrom stepped up at the offensive blue line there to try to keep that puck in. Didn't keep it in, but she had her third forward back, so that was a smart pinch by Molly there.
So you see Tessa Benham coming in on the offensive rush, and there's a shot and a great save made by Liz Knox. Back to live action here as Ashley Riggs will now take the puck in front of her bench as she's pressured by Mallory Deluce. This one's played up here as that is Carey Palmer that will have it. Corey Chevrolet battling along the boards there as Tara Gray will take it at center ice for Brampton. Plays it all the way back into her zone for Carey Palmer. Brooke Bees are all over Carey Palmer now as she's trying to add the pressure to her. Here's Jaina Hefford. Brittany Selena now skating in. Selena, the shot, that one goes just wide. Here's Tara Gray. Checked by Toronto. We have a scrum going down there as Ashley Riggs comes ahead. Ashley Riggs, the shot. Easy blocker save made there by Erica Vanderveer. Here's the little scrum going down in the corner now as Andrea Ironside comes away with it. Ironside tries to put the puck on net as that hit a stick and went high of the net. Ironside now battling for the puck as Jillian Apps will take control of it, puts it around the boards to Allie Fox. Courtney Burchard now. Here's a shot. That one's blocked in front. The rebound goes all the way to the stick of Christy Zamora. Zamora finally gets out of the zone, but it hits the linesman before it gets the half. Martine Garland with the puck now. This one's all the way back into the Toronto zone as Vanderveer will play it to Garland.
Seems that the momentum of this game has yet again shifted a little bit as Brampton was really putting on the pressure there.
Yep, Brampton's trying to get the ball back in their court, so to speak, to try to get more control of this game. Burchard now with the puck behind her own net. Burchard's going to turn and make sure that Rebecca Davies does not get to her. Skates by her. Great speed here by the defenseman Burchard. She gets around another defenseman. Here's a shot! Rifles it, and that one goes just high of the net.
Saw Burchard sort of put her head down after taking that shot. It was a great play to carry the puck all the way from her own end, and she knows that she could have hit the net there and had a good scoring chance. She has a great shot, but those need to be on the net.
Looks like we had an offside call there before Courtney Burchard went to take that shot. So the faceoff won by Toronto as Bowman will play the puck across to Callison. Plays up for Kelly Zamora. We have about 6:45 left here in the third period as McPhail will take the puck. Bryan having trouble with it as Hefford will take it, and we have another whistle. as we're going to have a holding call, holding penalty here, as it looks like we're going to have number 28, Brittany Salina, go off to the box here. So we're going to have a little another look at this penalty here to see where the hold was by Brittany Salina.
Bit of a questionable call on that play, in my opinion. I think Salina was just going for the puck there and sort of lost her balance at the end. I'm not sure where the holding call would have come
in. It's almost as if the hold came when she tried to not fall down and hold herself up using the player. So you're right, a questionable call there by the referees, but nonetheless, Brampton is back on the penalty kill. Scanzano now. As Vicky Bendis trying to play the puck all the way out. She cannot, as Scanzano keeps it in for Toronto. Scanzano plays the puck all the way back. Tessa Benum to Brittany Smith, who already has one in this period. To Benum. Benum the shot. That one's blocked in front and goes wide. Kelly Zamora now with the puck in the corner. Scanzano going in to help her out. She will play the puck back to Benum. Benum across. This is Scanzano to Smith. Smith looking to shoot. Cannot. One-timer chance there for Tessa Benum. That was blocked immediately by Vicky Bendis.
Again, we're seeing Toronto on the power play. If they can't capitalize here, I guarantee you at the end of this hockey game, they're going to be saying we had too many power play opportunities that we just didn't score on.
Yeah, you're absolutely right on that one, Megan. This puck has moved all the way up here. Cheverie trying to chip in there, but she is checked hard there by Hefford. Both of them now on the ground. And then we have the puck come all the way back out here as Tessa Benum will take it. Benum's taken down there by Sherry Piper. Battle for the puck going on here as we have a whistle. Just outside of the penalty box there, we had a whistle. And we will have a faceoff just outside of Brampton territory. Referee must have lost sight of the puck.
But I'm doing a good job there, making a quick, evasive move, trying to get away from the forechecker. Just gets taken out at the last second there. But that's something that Tessa Benum is very, very good at. She has a lot of poise and a lot of patience with the puck and uses a lot of deception in her game.
Arts now takes the puck, and she'll pass it to Brian, who will dump it in. We have about 5 minutes remaining here in the third period with a score of 3-2 now for Brampton. Here's the shot. Winds up Garland the shot, and that one goes just wide of the net. Breaking in now here is Vicky Bendis. Bendis with a lot of speed, as we mentioned earlier. She is a very talented player.
A smart play there, too, to carry the puck into the offensive zone. She had the time. She had the space. Even though they're on the penalty kill, she didn't just dump it down and give it away to the other team.
Andrea Ironside now taking the puck, and she'll play it back around for Molly Engstrom. Engstrom looking for space as she will play the puck all the way back. McPhail takes the puck. This one's taken. Ashley Riggs breaking in now. Riggs looking at the center of the pass when she had a lane, but that one's taken by Vanderveer and stopped. Now, should Ashley Riggs have just shot that puck instead of trying to center the pass?
In hindsight, perhaps, but when you're in the heat of the game, you make the decisions that you think are best at that time. So, yes, she could have shot it there, as we see right now. She could take the shot right there. But there's also that player that's wide open in the slot. So if that pass gets through, then no doubt she would say to herself, yes, I made the right play. I should have made that pass.
Yep. But right now she seems to be kicking herself a bit for that puck, hitting the stick of the defenseman in front of her and going right to Vanderveer. So now the puck is all the way back around here. Callison plays the puck all the way out to the point as Engstrom cannot hold it in. Engstrom plays the puck across to her partner, Allie Fox. Fox trying to play it in as Callison knocks it down. And another whistle here.
Not sure what happened there. Hefford's stick seemed to have gotten caught in one of the Toronto players' jerseys.
Yeah, we have a faceoff coming possibly here just outside of Brampton territory as we are back at even strength here with 3:52 remaining here at the Clarkson Cup, game number 5. Smith now will play the puck across for Tessa Benum.
Tessa Benum and Brittany Smith now out on the ice on defense for Toronto. We're going to be seeing a lot of them probably in these last 4 minutes here. They'll probably play the majority of the rest of the game.
Yep, they are very skilled defensemen. Of course, both of them part of Team Canada as well.
Brittany, former Team Canada.
Former, I apologize for that. My bad on that one. Here's Carrie Palmer, the shot. That one's blocked in front. And the rebound goes right to the stick of Sherry Piper, who fires it across. Great chance there for Lori Dupuy, but she cannot capitalize on it as Tessa Bonham with speed coming in. Bonham trying to shoot it, and that one hits a skate and goes wide.
A great play there by Bonham to skate the puck down the ice. You can tell that Toronto really wants this game. They want to score this goal and tie it up here.
Great moves there by Brooke Beezer as that one is taken away from her by Courtney Burchard. Apps now looking, and there's McPhail now. She shoots it in as Liz Knox will turn it aside. Garland now the shot. That one's blocked in front by her own teammate there, McPhail. Brian now battling for the puck. McPhail picks it up here. We got about 2 minutes and 27 seconds remaining here in the third period. And we have a takedown there, but no whistle on the play. Referee looks like they're going to let a little bit more leeway here go within the last couple minutes.
Vicky Bendis, not a big body, but she is a solid, solid player.
And we have an icing call here with 2 minutes and 14 seconds remaining in the third period here. And this will go all the way back to Brampton territory. Now, Brampton really needs to win this faceoff here to make sure that the momentum is out of Toronto's favor here in the last couple minutes.
Absolutely, and this is definitely an exciting hockey game to be watching. Hopefully all of the fans here are enjoying this.
Hoffmeyer now going to take the shot. That one stopped, tip just wide.
Great shot there by Hoffmeyer.
Scanzano now going to take the puck. She's pressured there by Burchard. This one's in front. Nice try on the centering pass there as this one's kept in by Martine Garland. Zamora now takes the puck. Kelly Zamora trying to center it out in front for Christie, but she cannot find her. So now breaking in is Jillian Apps as she will dump the puck all the way back down into Toronto territory behind their net. Martine Garland now takes the puck behind the net. Looking to set something up here with 1:37 remaining here in the third period. Has her pocket picked there by Jaina Hefford. Scanzano now cannot handle the puck as this one's across. Ashley Riggs plays it for Hefford. Jaina Hefford, shot. Great save made by Erica Vanderveer, and she will freeze to stop play.
Brampton seems to be controlling this hockey game right now. Only a minute and 20 seconds left. Toronto needs to win this faceoff and get the puck down into the Brampton end so that they can quite possibly and most likely pull their goalie to get the extra attacker on the ice.
And that would be a smart decision there by Toronto, especially with the momentum in their favor currently right now. So now Vanderveer you see skating out. Here's a break-in, and looks like the puck got tangled up there with Brooke Beezer. Beezer just lays out one of the forwards here on Team Brampton there, and that was Jaina Hefford. So now it looks like we're going to have a little bit of a discussion here between the referees as Brooke Beezer will go to the box for that big, big hit there.
I'm surprised there wasn't an initial call on the rush there. I believe it was Beezer that carried the puck down the ice and took it to the net, and Molly Engstrom took her down. I'm surprised that the refs didn't call anything there.
Yeah, so Brooke Beezer now going to go ahead to the box as we have a timeout here by Brampton. As it looks like Brooke Beezer will be in the box right now. Toronto and Brampton teams both going to schedule a good play to try to come up with something here as Toronto really wants to tie this game up.
Not a very smart play by Beezer there. Not a good time to take a penalty at all when your team is trying to tie the game up.
So now we're going to have another look here at the breakaway by Brooke Beezer as she came in. And this is where you said Molly Engstrom did take her down. We will find out right here. And, yeah, Molly Engstrom's skate getting caught up there with Brooke Beezer.
And it looked like Liz Knox came out with the poke check there too. So that could be my mistake there, and it could have been a good call by the ref to see that it was Knox that actually took out Beezer.
Yeah, and Brooke Beezer countered by taking out Jaina Hefford. So Brooke Beezer now going to be in the box here as we have 1 minute of play left here in the third period. Courtney Burchard now with the puck. She's going to play it down low. Lori Dupuy going to play it back for Burchard. Fox trying to center it in front now, but this will be taken by Dupuy. Dupuy looking down low for Riggs, but cannot find her. This one's going to be played back to the point for Fox. Fox to Burchard. This one's played all the way back around the net here for Bendis. Toronto takes possession of the puck now. They're going to play the puck across as Vanderveer looks like she's going to be pulled. No. Yep, she will be. As Lori Dupuy take the puck, and she will ice it with a goal, empty net goal here to make it 4-2. Vanderveer was undecided, it looked like, if she wanted to come out of the net or stay there.
Yeah, it seemed like there was a little bit of confusion on the bench there as to whether or not they wanted Vanderveer out of the net. But at this point in the game, there's 16 seconds left. They're killing a penalty. Really, Toronto had nothing to lose there. Taking that penalty, Beezer down in the offensive end, it really hurt Toronto's chances of being able to tie up the game.
With 16 seconds remaining here between Brampton and Toronto, we have Brampton up 4-2 here at the Clarkson Cup Gale Center in Niagara Falls. And Toronto is just looking to try to rebound from this one. But Jennifer Bryan will take the puck now with 5 seconds remaining here. This is Jennifer Sadler battling along the end boards there. This one's behind the net of Toronto, and that will do it as Brampton HC will defeat Toronto in their must-win game for this Clarkson Cup tournament.
Yeah, and you have to give Toronto a lot of credit for coming out in the third period the way they did, scoring those two quick goals and giving themselves an opportunity to get back in the game and giving themselves a chance to win. But taking a penalty that late in the game when you are absolutely needing a goal, I think it crippled the team in that last minute there.
Yeah, Brooke Beezer's costly penalty right there made Toronto basically give up that empty net goal on and have Brampton ice the game. Now, what did you find that Brampton did right going into the final period?
Going into the final period, it seems like they let up a bit in the first, 6 or 7 minutes, Toronto getting those two goals. But a smart coaching play there by Brampton to call the timeout, regroup their players, bring everybody in and say, hey, you know what, we still have the lead in this game. If we go back to the basics, go back to our strength, they're a great puck-moving team. It seems like at that point they really regrouped and were able to take control back of the game.
Now we're going to have the three-star ceremony here in the Gale Center. Final score of this game was 4-2 for Brampton. Shots were 30-27 for them as well. We had a very exciting game, very evenly matched teams. But do you feel that Brampton's penalties didn't really come back to haunt them in the end?
They didn't come back to haunt them in the end too bad because Toronto was not able to capitalize on their power play the way that they needed to. And I think that that's something going back into the dressing room at the end of this game, they're going to be saying to themselves, we had all those power play opportunities and we needed to capitalize on them.
And that is really what cost Toronto the game.
And now
the goaltending situation with Liz Knox, she did a very good job today. We've seen that great save from her as well from the first period. Now Liz Knox, of course, this is the third game straight game that she's played. We have not seen Sonia Vanderbeek at all for Brampton. Now Liz Knox carrying this team, it seems like.
Yes, and it'll be interesting to see. I would guess that Brampton would come back with
second
Liz Knox tomorrow in the final
Brampton
game, but that'll be 4 games for her in 4 days. That is a lot of hockey. In the same breath, these Brampton players, they have to be tired. 4 games in 4 days. You can't lie to yourself. The legs are going to be a little bit heavy, and it's a relatively quick turnaround to a 1 o'clock game tomorrow.
And there you see Vicky Bendis getting the second star of the game today. The third star of the game was Jesse Scanzano.
Number 9, Molly.
And Molly Engstrom getting the first star of the game here in Game 5 of the Clarkson Cup at the Gale Center here in lovely Niagara Falls. Once again, Brampton beating Toronto by the score of 4-2. We've seen a great game today. And Megan, what can we see tomorrow from Brampton to come out and play in the final game?
Brampton, I think, right now is key just to to get as much rest as they possibly can and make sure that they're ready to come play a tough game tomorrow. You know, if they're facing Montreal, and we'll see Montreal and Boston this afternoon, it's definitely going to be a very tough game. So I think that from Brampton tomorrow, we'll need to see solid goaltending again from Liz Knox and maybe a little bit more offense from the forwards.
And that was a great game that we've seen today. And we're going to send it now down to Nico Cardarelli, who has an interview for us. Final score here at the Gale Center was 4-2.